We were given an emergency permission from the state and from federal fish and wildlife agencies to preserve this genetic lineage.
Beautiful.
She is pretty.
Blunt-nosed leopard lizard. Yeah.
We can actually use a skill set that we've developed to actually bolster and rebuild a population that is declining. And that, in my mind, is a big portion of why zoos exist. What we're doing here is basically what these apes would experience out in nature in a lot of ways. This is the culmination of all of our work, which hopefully will result in a baby blunt-nosed leopard lizard. And each egg has a viable blastocyst or embryo. You can see that red circle. So this is actually a blunt-nosed leopard lizard embryo. You can see the first little baby blunt-nosed leopard lizard making its way out here. Why I got into zookeeping is basically things like this project, where we can directly see and measure the impact that we're having. We can put 100 blunt-nosed leopard lizards back in the field and then track them. Then once that population reproduces and has its own offspring, we know that we've helped to seed that population back in place. That's something that's a measurable impact that we as zookeepers and zoo professionals can have, where we can go back and look at something that we're doing and actually visually see the impact of having that animal repatriated to the wild.
They're super feisty, just right out of the egg.